discussing capabilities, I neglected to mention that during my tenure as tax assessor, I was certified by the state. One thing, when we had the insurance company, 90% of our premiums were collected via bank draft. And while I was in office, I tried to get that approved so the taxpayers could, if they chose, to pay by monthly bank draft. I was unable to do it, but if reelected, I'm gonna try to get that through again. I know that at least the seniors, it would be a lot better on a lot of us to have monthly payments instead of one big payment at the end of the year. I appreciate your votes, trying to get back and do the job that I really, really enjoy doing. Thank you.
The reason I decided to run remains unchanged. The unfortunate, fragile tradition seeping throughout our country made it clear to me we need a solid, fundamental change of thought process, and it can start at the local level and work its way up. We must get out of business, make smart choices, limit distractions, and serve our citizens. As a parent and a grandparent, I am invested in this community. The tax dollars I pay each and every year go to the betterment of infrastructure and education, to the running of the business of our local government. This not only impacts the current generation, but it impacts the future generation as well. That is our children, grandchildren, and their families. We're all in this together, and we must make our votes and our voice count. Together we stand, and divided we fall. Your vote for Brenda is a vote for integrity. Your vote for Brenda is a vote for accountability. Your vote for Brenda is a vote for someone who will be accessible. Your vote for Brenda is a vote for fairness. Your vote for Brenda is a vote for a tax assessor who knows that I am not number one, you are. Your vote for Brenda Samples for tax assessor collector can be cast early, voting February 16th through the 26th and Tuesday, March 1st. My name is Brenda Samples, and I do approve this message.
I too want to thank everyone for staying so late tonight, and particularly want to thank my husband who goes with me at all these forums and all these events. He's so faithful to be with me. Now, the tax assessor position is very important because so many millions of our dollars pass through this office. Our honor registrations and our elections are run through this office. Your everyday customer service comes through this office. Earlier, you heard my opponent subtly suggest that I'm somehow not worthy of being elected because we pay different property tax amounts. I am a taxpayer, and as insulting as that is, let's remember that that is being said to make you look away from her lack of qualifications. Let's just get down to it. In this race, there are three people. I have two opponents. One of my opponents is a very nice gentleman. He's so nice that he didn't have proper audit controls in place and somebody stole from him while he was the tax assessor. My other opponent has nothing to recommend her except her disdain for disabled veterans who take their legal tax exemption. I'm the one who brought a higher level of professionalism to this office. I have the education, experience, leadership, and management that this office needs and my opponents don't have. I want to continue to serve you as your tax assessor. But good government doesn't happen by chance. You have to put the right people in the right place, so it's up to